Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and in today's video I'm going to bring you the very best mods available for Jurassic World Evolution 2. This is a curated list, I would like to say, of the 8 or so best mods that currently are guaranteed to work in your version of Jurassic World Evolution 2. That's version 1.5. These are all mods that I've tested myself to make sure they function together correctly and that I'm running in this save file right now that you're watching. So you know that as long as you install everything correctly, nothing's going to go wrong. That said, big old disclaimer, mods can break existing save files, and especially when the game updates down the line, mods can then run into trouble then as well. It seems to be less of a big deal at the moment when we're not doing new species and stuff like that, but it is worth keeping in mind. You do take that risk yourself. It's not the mod maker's fault, it's not my fault, and it's most certainly not Frontier's fault. Please, people, stop bugging Frontier when you break your game with mods. Okay, so what we're going to do in this video is I'm going to show you what each of these 8 mods do, and at the end I'm going to very briefly show you how to install them. It is super duper easy. I know people get a little bit intimidated by it, but I promise absolutely anybody can do it. So what are those 8 mods? Let's take a look. Since we're currently in the era of no new species, etc., all these mods are really focused around expanding your utilities in the game, around your creativity, stuff like that. You can see here that we've got a lot of things stacked together. We've got water decorations above the ground, as you can see over here. There's a lot of things we can do that you can't do in the base game that just open up your capabilities as a park designer a little bit. So this is the list. First of all, we have the expanded islands / expanded parks mod by IloDev, i.e. Anaki, and basically that does what it says on the tin. It takes away the usual map boundaries, which are sort of around here and around here, and instead it gives you the whole square to play with. So you can build in some slightly funky areas like here behind the airport, as you can see, and it really just gives you a whole lot more space to build on. It also means you can flatten those obnoxious mountains, etc., on some of the other maps that get out of the way. And the best thing about this really is it just lets you build on any map. You can pick your favorite map and build on it without having to worry about whether it's too small, etc., etc. Number 2 on our list is also by IloDev, and that is expanded decorations vehicles. If you come down to your decorations tab over here after installing the mod and scroll down to the bottom, you'll see 10 new vehicles that you can just place anywhere in your park like so. We've got helicopters, vans, motorcycles, if you wanted to do a Jurassic World Owen Grady kind of thing, station wagon, tractors. We've got big trucks, we've got little trucks, we've got everything you could possibly want. You could build yourself a parking lot, you could do abandoned facilities, you could recreate scenes from the film, etc., etc. There aren't many decoration mods at this point in time, if any, other than this one, so this is a really useful one. Definitely an area I'd love to see expanded upon further down the line. Frontier has done a much better job this time around, of course, giving us decorations, but more options is always a great thing. The final mod on this list, not made by Kyodenic, is expanded hunting by Mr. Sig. And what this basically does is adds 2 primary new behaviors to the hunting in the game to make it a little bit more interesting. Now multiple dinosaurs can join in a hunt at different times, even 2 T-Rexes, 3 T-Rexes can hunt the same dinosaur and appear at different times to partake in that hunt. It also adds, more importantly, a really cool looking stalking behavior. I'm going to show you that in just a second, where dinosaurs will creep up on their prey until they get just about close enough that they can burst forward and attempt to take them down. It looks really, really cool. It's just like what a real predator would do. It's absolutely phenomenal stuff and I highly recommend it. So I'm going to show you a quick clip of that right now. Now it is worth noting that if you don't want to use this, there is also expanded behaviors made by Kyodenic, which adds some really cool things to the game, like omnivorous dinosaurs. I think if you went in and edited these, you could maybe make both work, but as it stands, expanded behaviors will overwrite Mr. Sig's hunting and it won't work. So I'm about to use lots of Kyodenic mods. I like to mix it up a little bit and I love the stalking behavior so much. I would personally use expanded hunting by Mr. Sig over expanded behaviors by Kyodenic, but you can use one or the other. Just make sure you choose appropriately for what your needs are. The next 5 mods are all made by Kyodenic, who is a little bit of a god. I will praise them until the end of my days. The first one then is expanded terrain tools. If we come into our environment tools here, go down to the bottom to our terrain editing, you can see we've got lots of options here. And now we can put that in use. We can make really sharp steeps, some really deep pits and stuff like that. It basically just takes away the limits. Usually this would be very, very gradiated off to the side. It doesn't let you make sharp hills. It tends to smooth it all out. This just kind of takes away those limits, gives you much better tools in terms of your options as well, and really just makes building natural things or building with the environment a whole lot easier. Highly, highly, highly recommend this one. It was one of the first mods made for good reason. Next up from Kyodenic, we have Expanded Sandbox. Now, a few of the ideas in this mod are no longer necessary because Frontier has since integrated those same ideas into the game. I'm not saying a word about that, but what it will do is give you a few cool new options. If we go into operations here, you can see we can add the monorail arrival point. We can also scroll down to the bottom and add in the research compound from the Jurassic World Dominion expansion, like so. And if we go into enclosures, we can scroll down to attractions, we can scroll down and add the amphitheater from Jurassic Park San Diego. So you can now bring all these buildings on to any map you choose and integrate them into your builds. Next up, we have one of my favorite and I would suggest most underrated mods is Expanded Speed Controls by Kyodenic. And it basically, instead of just having the regular fast forward like we have down here, there's a little tooltip you can check out on the mod page, but it lets you do things like this. So I'm gonna hit the equals key a few times. Now, this might not seem very useful, but it is for various reasons. I mean, if you wanted to... Okay, maybe it's not that useful for everyone, but for me personally, if I'm trying to get my dinosaurs to do something specific, if I'm trying to get hunt to happen for a video purpose, if I'm trying to get certain animations to happen, then the ability to use speed controls is immensely helpful. It really is. And you can also, if we hit the correct button, slow things right down so you can get some really cool shots. That slow motion camera has been taken out of the game now, but if you use the correct speed control buttons, you can now integrate it and get some nice shots for your machinima or whatever it is you're vibing with. Really, really useful mod. It comes in handy more than you think, and it's just fun to play around with more than anything else. Let's reset that. Just two more to go. Next up is the number one mod I would recommend if you're trying to be a park builder and you're, you know, willing to use mods, and that is Free Build, also by Kyodenic. And what that very simply does, let's put down a path so we can display this, is it gets rid of the limitations when placing things on other things. So for example, usually if I want to place a fence, it'll go down to the path and you'd get to about here and it would stop. You wouldn't be able to place it any further. But with Free Build, I can just la da 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 da, and you can see I can cross the fence over itself a billion times if I want to do that. It just gets rid of those limitations, the hitbox limitations on your items. Of course, that applies mainly in terms of being useful to decorations. So if you wanted, you can build kind of fancy fountains by layering them all together, stuff like that. I mean, that's rubbish, but you can do it. You stick a skeleton in there if you wanted to. The point is, it's going to let you build a lot more freely when it comes to your decorations. If you're going to use mods, this is the number one mod I would recommend in terms of expanding your park building capabilities. I recommend most PC players use mods personally, but you know, I can definitely see why people don't and why it freaks people out a little bit. And if you want to wait until the game's completely finished updating, as in no new content, no new updates ever coming, which is what I'm personally doing for Planet Zoo, then I totally understand that, because as I say, I'm doing the same thing for other games. Right, last on the list, this one is a little bit more niche, but if you want to get really creative with your park building, I would recommend it. This is Kai's Wii Toolbox by Kyodenic, and it's madness. So it adds a gizmo to the game, which we activate. We're going to hit N for that one, the move tool, freeform, and it lets you pick things up, including dinosaurs. As you can see, if you can do this to a dinosaur that's being pack hunted and drag it away from its predator dinosaurs, which is very entertaining, but you can pick up dinosaurs and stuff like that. That's all well and good. But when it comes to buildings, we can do some crazier things. So let's say we've got our little Chronosaurus habitat. So over here, we've got a research outpost. And if I hit the N key, you can see I get all these options at the bottom of the screen. I can grab hold of this research outpost and move it around and put it into weird locations. But I can do a lot more than that. If I hold X, for example, I can rotate it along the X axis. If I want to reset that, I just right click. If I hit Y, I can rotate it around like that. And if I hit Z, I can rotate it like that. Now you might be thinking why you'd ever want that, but again, if you're going to build like a destroyed park or something like that, maybe toppling over some buildings, etc., could come in handy. If you hold B, you can also smooth it up and down. So that's why I personally use this mod most of the time. So let's say you want to build a Jurassic Park the game inspired lagoon. You'd grab your research outpost, you'd move it over here, you then hold B and you just drop it into the water like so. And now that will actually stay down there, and okay, I've put it in an okay place, and you can see now we have an underwater viewing area and it works completely correctly. So if I take this and then add the Hyperloop connection, if I have a hyper, yeah, we've got Hyperloop over here, so let's add the Hyperloop together, you'll see this, you know, completely works as well. It'll work, it'll move up and down as need be. We're moving up right now, so you can have these underwater viewing towers. You can add a lot of excitement to your lagoons. Especially, we just got some fantastic decorations for the lagoons, but of course now you can make it a little bit crazy. You can even stand outside in the water if you're that way inclined. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing well. I love your video.
Thank you, Kronosaurus. So those would be my top 8 most recommended mods for Jurassic World Evolution as of version 1.5. Apparently I forgot about a mod until right now. I have one more to show you actually. That is Expanded Feeders, also by Kyodenic. This does two very cool things. Let's go into our feeders here. The first is it adds invisible feeders for carnivore feeders, for the live prey feeder, and even for the piscivore feeder if you're that way inclined. Would look better in water, but the point is you can hide these in the right location. It gives your carnivores a more naturalistic approach to their habitat. If you want to get even fancier with it, it will give you two other options, and that is the ability to have auto dino spawners. I'm not going to go into that too much right now. I do have a video on that already if you want to check it out. Timed programmable dispenser. Also, Kyodenic's got a fantastic video I recommend as well. And basically, if we activate this, you see this timer starts to tick down over here. Time left 147. I'm just going to set timer T equals 5. And you can see that's set down to 5 seconds. And wait for it. Any second now. Boop. So now every 5 seconds, this little timer is going to make a Gallimimus. And you can change the species. You can have population limits. You can change the skins and the patterns of all these. It's really good for having auto-populating parks when you've got carnivores hunting around, stuff like that. If you want to set up a realistic Site B, I really recommend the Expanded Feeders mod. Completely forgot about it until just now, but yeah, this one works completely well with version 1.5 as well, so I highly, highly recommend it, as you can see. This will now make Gallimimuses for all of time. So you've made your way to a mod page. Congratulations! I will link all these down below, of course. This is nexusmods.com/Jurassic World Evolution 2, but all 11 mods you'll see in a second from today's video will be linked down below. Let's just go through very quick basic installation. It really is very simple. What you're going to do though, you're going to come onto here, you're going to go into files, and you're going to click manual download on whatever the main file is. None of the mods from today will require alternate files or any weird stuff, so you're just going to click manual download. That's going to give you a zip file that you're then going to unzip using WinRAR, WinZip, 7-Zip, whatever your zip program of choice is. So you've unzipped your file, you'll get something like this for the, this is the hunting mod, for example. You don't want to click into this. You're just going to have this file right here like this, and you're going to drag and drop into your Jurassic World Evolution 2 OVL data folder. So that is in, for most people, it may be different for you, but for the majority of people, your local disk, your program files, depending on your version of Windows, but program files, something, Steam, Steam apps, Common, Jurassic World Evolution 2, Win64, OVL data. And all you have to do for the vast majority of these mods is drag and drop the file into this little bit here. That is all you have to do. And what I like to do personally when I've got mods is also do this. I use a program called Colorize, as you can see, and I make them a fancy color, because that way I kind of just see which are my modded files and which are my unmodded files. So if I want to change things up for when an update comes out, it's very easy to do. What you may notice, of course, is that I have 11 green files here and only 8 mods shown in today's video. That's because for these mods to work, they do have a couple of dependencies, and I think this is the primary way people are going wrong when it comes to their game not working with mods, so let's go check those out now. The main file you're going to want for a lot of these to work is ACSE, Awesome Cobra Script Extender, which is quite an ironic name now, I believe, but either way, ACSE, you can again get this on Nexus, and I will again link this down below. This should be the first thing you change when the game updates. If your mod stopped working or if a mod isn't working for you, make sure you come into files and you've downloaded the latest version of ACSE. This is where it's going to be. Just make sure you're keeping up to date with the newest version of ACSE, and just like with the other mod I showed you before, you just want to install that into your OVL data folder. All of these mods will have instructions on how to install them, but that is all you have to do for any of them anyway. Dead easy. There are, however, a couple of other dependencies you're going to want to grab, and I suspect this is maybe where people are making the main mistakes, and that is you're going to want the files KiCore General, and you can see here it's listed as 1.5, which is the version we're currently on. So go into Files, download manually, and just drag and drop into your game folder like you would with every other mod. You're also going to need KiCore Menu, another of Cryodynamics things, and both of these are just bundles of code that do certain things in the game that let Cryodynamics mods work. I'm not going to pretend to understand it, but I suspect most people who are having problems with Cryodynamics mods, and as I've said, they don't all currently work, the expanded foliage one, for example, doesn't currently work, etc. But the ones that do work, the ones I've shown you in this video, all six of those Cryodynamics mods in this video, do currently work on version 1.5, and if you're having problems with them, I suspect it's either installing into the wrong folder, as I say, all of them just go into the Oval Data folder, or you haven't updated your KiCore Menu and your KiCore General, both of which should be version 1.5. So definitely come on here and have a look when you last downloaded it and stuff like that. And that's about it from me, ladies and gentlemen. So 9 fantastic mods that will give you much more creative control, much more power in your Jurassic World Evolution 2 park building. Of course, you can still do some absolutely remarkable things without any mods whatsoever. If you want to see some people do that, Evolution Square does all of her park builds unmodded, as far as I know, and is immensely creative. And there are tons of immensely creative, skilled people out there posting their work on the subreddit, on Discord, and on the Nexus. But if you want to give yourself a little bit more power, if you want to build a crazy ass Gallimimus filled park, or you want to sink buildings into the ground, or you want to stick lots of things together, or have invisible feeders, or go super duper fast, actually that's not a bad idea, then you know, you can have that capability as well. It's completely up to you. I don't judge people for using mods or for not using mods. It's just an option, and options I think are always a pretty cool thing. This is madness. So personally, these are the 9 I would recommend. They all work perfectly well at this current point in time. I've shown you them working right here in version 1.5. you can download these safely, trusting that they do currently work. Before we go, again, if you're having any problems, if you're finding that mods aren't working for you, I would suggest the main thing to do is update your ACSE, your KiCore General, and your KiCore Menu. Make sure they're all in the Oval Data folder correctly, and if that's all done, you really shouldn't have any problems. That should fix all of the major issues. You've seen the mods working, you know they work, there is a problem somewhere else. But if people did find this helpful, I'd love to keep doing it, because I think this is a really cool thing that people can do and would, you know, maybe increase their love and time spent with the game. And I think people maybe find it a little bit intimidating. But I'm not like massively computer savvy or anything like that. You don't have to be. It's very simple stuff once you can get your head around it, and hopefully this has helped. You know these mods work. If you've been tempted to give it a try but you've resisted till now, this should be a really good jumping off point for any of you at home. Of course, we'll update this a little bit more in the future. New species, etc. will be part of this down the line. You know, I recommend the best new species mods to download. We're not there yet in terms of the new species. They're being cautious, ironing out all the kinks, etc., etc., which I totally understand. I'm not sure exactly when that will appear, but I'm sure it will appear at some point, and of course we'll be all over that when it does. People are hard at work, and you've got to keep in mind, for all of these mod makers, for all the people whose stuff you've seen today, who I've been so lucky to be able to showcase to you over the years, they don't get paid for this. This isn't a job, this is something they do on the side, this is a hobby, this is a side thing, this is something they do out of love for the game and for love for the community. So, you know what, if a mod doesn't work, or has a frustrating aspect, or you want to see a new mod or something, I beg you all, because I see some horrible comments on the Nexus, please at least be nice and courteous and polite when talking to these people, because they are giving up their time to bring you something cool for free. And that's a great thing. So, you know, let's show them the respect they deserve. And especially to people like IloDev, etc. as well, who are responsible for the very foundation of the mod making we have here, along with some other people on the modding discords like Harlequins, etc. Right. I'm gonna go. So, thank you very much for joining me. If you did enjoy this video and found it helpful, please do throw me a like down below. If I missed any, feel free to let me know. I don't think I did. Out of the ones I would currently recommend, ones that 100% work, but let me know if you think otherwise. And there are many Gallimimuses in my park. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.